don't think you need that to be translated, eh? Okay. Colleagues, firstly, thank you, Speaker, also the constituency. Thank you to the community leaders for the invitation. I know some of you were expecting my predecessor, Minister Madikizela, but I've got bad news. I'm the new Minister of Human Settlements. He is no more. And as the new minister, I have a new vision for this department, which I will share with you so that you can understand where I am heading. But my vision also includes the broader community of Hermanus, because the Western Cape belongs to all and Hermanus belongs to all. Let me just emphasize that. Now, one of the biggest issues that I have picked up since becoming minister is people are becoming impatient because they've been waiting for too long. Secondly, promises have been made which have never materialized. And lastly, when some of these promises materialize, it ends up that the wrong people are getting houses across our province. So I've actually asked that we first look at the housing waiting lists of all our municipalities, because we need to stop the corruption when it comes to the housing waiting lists. We can't have people that have been on the waiting list for a long time still waiting, and young people getting houses. That is very wrong. So that is the first thing that I have changed. Then secondly, there are certain projects across this province which I have asked to accelerate so we can finally get it to be started to be implemented. But that project also needs to have funding, and that funding has been made available. So remember, Mkasela, the project for Hermanus, which you have spoken of, is one of my 7 projects that I have accelerated. And that project will deliver nearly 7,500 housing opportunities for the greater people of Hermanus. That's number one.
Okay.
But now I'm coming to scope, because that's why you are all here. Is it not? Now what I'm going to ask you, and please hear me out. Please do not occupy, or if you see people attempting to occupy scope, please stop them. Because it makes life difficult once the project is going to be launched on the scope ground. Now we are nearly in the final leg of the process with the owners of that land to actually acquire the land, so we as the province can start building our project. So that's my humble plea to you as the community leaders here. Within the next 2 to 3 weeks, the deal will be finalized. Then I will come back to have a feedback meeting with this leadership in this community to outline how the process will be and what the value of that project is going to be. Now, I'm not a guy that makes empty promises. I make commitments. But if I make a commitment as the minister, and I'm talking to the community leaders and to you as the broader community, I need just one commitment from you. Please, that land is going to be utilized to alleviate your living conditions. We are going to build quality housing units which you will ultimately live in. But do not let people illegally occupy our land, please. Because that makes life difficult. That will prolong the project rollout. That's the only commitment I want from you. Do I have that commitment from you as the community? Now you guys are quiet. Okay. Then lastly, because Hermanus belongs to all, the project which will be rolled out here is going to be integrated. It's going to include other areas as well. But what we are going to do, I am aware that some of you have been living in backyards for a very long time. I am aware that there are a lot of elderly people on the waiting list. I am aware there's people with disability on the waiting list. I am aware that there are single households where young people, due to their parents dying, are now responsible for their siblings. I have recently, a week ago, signed a directive to all municipalities to change the way that they distribute the houses when it comes to the waiting list. It will now be 50-50, which means we will look at the elderly, we will look at the people with disability, we will look at the households headed by young people. But for the first time in the province, we are going to prioritize people that live in the backyards as well. Then the second thing I have done, this province's guideline says that we stop at 35, starting from the oldest and go to 35. I have now expanded that definition to include up until 30 years old. Because the project that we are going to build here in Hermanus, we are going to build a specific number of units for young people. That's why, because our young people are the ones that are becoming impatient. So I am here to cater for the youth as well, but I need to work, you guys to work with me. But believe me, your wait is going to be over very, very soon. And I will come back in the next 3 to 3.5 weeks for a follow-up meeting with fine with the community leadership. Then I will give you the thorough detail of how that project is going to look, how those units are going to look, and when it's exactly going to start. And I will be here when that project starts, and I will be here when I hand over the first houses to you. Because that is a commitment that I made. I am here to change your lives. Because you have elected me, irrespective of party politics. We are your servants. We must serve you. And that is what I will do for the next 5 years. Thank you very much.